Saddha. Saddha is often translated as faith or conviction in the English language. And faith here refers specifically to faith in the triple gems, namely the Buddha's enlightenment, the Dharma that he taught, and the Sangha. We must first know the difference between faith and knowing. Faith is based on beliefs, which means that the facts have not been fully established. On the other hand, if the facts have been established, then there is no longer necessary to believe or have faith. Instead, it is knowing the truth for what it is, and it is referred to as wisdom or panya. That is why this spiritual journey begins with faith and ends with knowledge and vision, panya. So the question is, why is it important to have faith in the triple gem? Faith in the Buddha's enlightenment. It is important to have faith in the Buddha's enlightenment because only when you believe that the Buddha has achieved enlightenment that you can be sure that his teachings are true. If the Buddha has not achieved enlightenment but claimed to be enlightened, then we will have doubts about the accuracy and authenticity of his teachings. Thus, faith in the enlightenment of the Buddha is the first step in our spiritual journey. However, as beginners, with inadequate study of the suttas and inadequate knowledge about the Buddha's teachings, we may not be able to properly judge the Buddha's highest achievement. We do not know for certain yet whether the Buddha truly is an enlightened being or not. To be frank, we will not know for sure until and unless we become enlightened ourselves. That is why faith is still required. Faith in the Dhamma. On the other hand, we can experience for ourselves the truth of the Buddha's teachings by putting his teachings into practice. This is a case of the proof of the pudding is in the eating. As we practice and experience the truth of his teachings, our faith in his enlightenment increases proportionately. Further proof of the truth of his teachings can also be seen from the scientific studies on the effects of those practicing his teachings, such as monks and meditators. For example, it has been shown that a peaceful and compassionate mind can ease physical illnesses, such as rheumatoid arthritis. As more studies found that mental health is intimately related to our physical well-being, and positive mental states are conducive for a happy, healthy, and long life, our faith in his teachings grow. Faith in the Sangha. During the Buddha's time, the Sangha is made up of many arahants. Thus, it was probably easier then to have absolute faith in the Sangha. In modern time, the situation is different. No doubt there are still many good monks and nuns who earnestly practice the Buddha's teachings and have tasted the fruit of their effort and cultivation. However, there are many too who join the Sangha without much motivation to practice, but simply to enjoy the privileges that come with their position as Sangha members. So it is important to be discerning in this respect. When we are asked to pay respect to and to have faith in the Sangha, what we are actually doing is to pay respect to and have faith in the Maha Sangha, which is representative of the entire Sangha, not the individual monk. We pay them due respect because it is the Sangha that continues to preserve and propagate the teachings of the Buddha. How to strengthen faith? Our conviction in the Triple Gems can be strengthened by reading the suttas, recalling the suttas, discussing the suttas, and teaching the suttas. In other words, familiarizing ourselves with the suttas and having a thorough understanding of the Dhamma is the best way to strengthen our faith in the spiritual practice. Faith versus doubt. Apart from faith, the Buddha also mentioned doubt in the suttas. Doubt is one of the five hindrances in our spiritual practice, and is one of the lower fetters that prevents one from attaining the stream entry. The Buddha has a good prescription for doubt. In the Kalama Sutta, found in Anguttara Nikaya 3.65, when asked how to tell what is true from what is not, the Buddha advised the Kalamas to weigh it against these four criteria. 1. Is it skillful? In other words, does it reduce greed, hatred, and delusion? 2. Is it blameless? That is, does it cause no harm to oneself and to others? 3. Is it praised by the wise? Would an arhan or a wise man approve of it? And 4. When put into practice, does it bring about good or beneficial results? So whenever we are faced with doubt with regards to whether a teaching is true Dharma or not, we should remember to put it through this test. The beginner's right view and right intention. Why is faith in the Triple Gems considered the seed to our spiritual path? This is because with this faith, the beginner's mind is born with the right view of the Buddha's enlightenment and the truth of his teachings, which leads to developing the right intention or aspiration to take refuge in the Triple Gems, to learn and to put into practice the teachings of the Buddha. This will be the beginning of a wonderful path to the development of our spirituality, starting with the purification of our dana or generosity and sila, moral conduct, through to our bhavana or mental cultivation, until we attain panya, wisdom and liberation.